Shalom. All praises go to the Most High Yahweh. Basham Yahashah, Basham of the Wakwadash. Double honor, son to the elder. Pause is a great millstone for the teachings of the scriptures, among other things. And Shalom to the sincere Akim across the world. Now, I wanted to make a quick video because I saw something in a thing in a series that was made in 2015. This is a series called Limitless, right? And it only has 116. It's very, I wouldn't say great. The movie was doper than a sack of Yola Holder. See? The movie was greater, was doper. And you already have these type of herbs. You have herbs that can make you... You have herbs that can make you... benefits, right? You have herbs that can make you that can work on your mind. Gotu-kola has the ability to enhance memory and nerve function and other things. Okay, these devils are not going to tell you everything because they're devils. They're only going to tell you 10, but there's a many. Don't worry about this. They're the devil. They're lying to you. Now, some other herbs, they do have side effects, like, for example, neem. Don't drink too much. You should only drink neem for like 2 weeks, because if you continue, then your seed will die, and then you will not be able to make a girl pregnant. That could be good for certain people that, you know, bust nuts in females. I still would not suggest it to you. But you can do that. That's an alternative to doing a vasectomy, if I'm correct. I think they do that in America, the vasectomy. That's when they cut off... Man, that's just fucked up. But they cut off something down there, and then you will not be able to get a girl pregnant. Man, that's just off. You'd rather just use nature, Heavenly Father, his things, which is neem oil, which leaves, for example. You can just use the leaves. It grows in India, just all over the place, but it grows in Suriname, and it's just people see this as weed. They see it as weed, like this weed. This one. Weed. They see it like something that you just throw away. Like something that is nothing. This is actually something, but it's being called weed. This is, how you call that thing again? Nettles. Yeah, it's very good for certain particular things. Nettles, drinks. You can, don't Google it. Go to Yandex, and then you should go here, you know? For example, and then you go here, then you go that, and then you type the same thing on Google, then you will see that, you know, they come up with like kind of the same, almost the same things. But when you go to like real cures, like this word, yeah, Google is very that's like kryptonite for Google, you know. But anyway, now going on. Not to make this video too long, because I'm already jumping to other stuff. Sorry about that. You can do this with neem. You know, you can dilute it like this, and then you can put it in water, and then you can make it into this or oil, right? And then you could put it on your body, or you can put it in water, and then the may. Watch out for the may. That's a caucus word. This is a caucus word. But they're the devil. Let me explain it better to you. Ronnie Coleman, he took the same steroids as everybody else at that time, but his genetic DNA was far more different. Of course, everybody's DNA is different, but it took the chemicals better compared to everybody else. What the? Sorry. Okay, you're right. He took the same dope as everybody else. Dopamine, whatever they call that thing, steroids, whatever. He took the same thing as everybody else, but he just got bigger. He just got bigger. Why? Because of his DNA. So if you was to teach people like, you're not gonna get this big, and then on the, like, for example, he took 10, right? And then he took 10, and then the doctors were, for example, I'm just giving an example, just, you know, just to give an example of a fact. The doctor would say, oh yeah, you, I'll give you 10 and you, I'll give you 10, but you're not gonna, you know, get any bigger or have more or be stronger, whatever. He gets the 10 pills or whatever, and he gets the 10 pills or 10 milligrams. I don't know. I'll just give an example. And then he grows to this. He was 100% from normality. He was 100% from normal. Everybody's normal, so you're 100%. Wow. With those 10, he grows to 250%. He grows to 250. But he, with the same thing, he grows to 300%, for example. And then you look at him and he look at you like, huh? How are we different? Yeah, that's because your DNA. So that's the only way that you can explain this. Certain people, when they take an herb, right, it might not affect them as how it would affect another person, even though they take the same amount. But the snake tongue people, they would not explain that to you because they're... Why would they explain that to you? Just a question. Like, why would these people that are the deceivers of the world, why would they... You see what I just did? I showed you why they wouldn't explain that to you. Because that's not their job. That's not their job. That's why they are not the righteous. Lord willing, the one that are trying to be right. Look, all of our righteousness is as filthy rags. But does that mean that we should not try and be righteous? Does that mean that? Because if that is not the truth, then why don't you just suck a pit? Why don't you go suck a Skittles boy his pee pee? I mean, you're gonna be forgiven, right? You're gonna be forgiven anyway, right? I mean, you're an Israelite, right? You're gonna be in the kingdom anyway, eventually, right? So why don't you go just suck pee pee then? You know, suck a caucus pee pee at that. You're not gonna do that because you don't want to. That's one. Second, you know that's filth. Third. You know you're gonna be destroyed for that. So yeah, because I have seen people, you know, and say stupid stuff like, yeah, but we gonna die all, we gonna be in the kingdom anyway, so it doesn't matter, you know. We're gonna be in the kingdom anyway, so I could just commit adultery, I could just do whatever I want right now because I'm still gonna be saved. To a certain degree, that's true. But how should I say this? It's like this. When you go around and have sex with everybody, every female, just this normal straight on straight sex, with every female up on the that you can find, and then when you get that AIDS, then you're gonna be very sorry that you slept with that particular individual person. You're gonna be very sorry. You're gonna wish that you never did that. Or any type of disease, you know? You're gonna do the I wanna type in another one, but I'm not gonna do that. I'll just stick with the one that they themselves admit to be true. So I'll stick to this. Anyway, you go take a vaccine from these you know, these Edomites, they come in love. They come in all love and beauty, and that's what they represent. They represent, I love you. I'm so full of love toward you, and I think you're such a beautiful race of people, and I want to multiply you and keep you beautiful in all your perfection. And I want to not correct you, but I want to enhance you. How about that? Beautiful words, snake tongue. Like a real black and white thing, but everywhere. Anyway, so they come and then they so-called help you and all that there. But I would hope that you know about the Tuskegee syphilis experiment. It was not an experiment. They know what would happen to you, because the experiment that happened on the rats. On the rats that they have in the laboratorium. You were not an experiment. You was a project. Like a you're a project. You're a subject, but they're going to do a project on you anyway. So I hope you just understand what I just trying to explain, that they are like the May. Let me see. You just don't trust these people, man. You know, they're lying to you. The other explanation for the May prevent thing, that's because some people, when they take the same thing as you, they might not get the same effect as you. You know, some people might die, and so some people might not die from the same deadly thing that you took and he took, the same amount. Just don't trust these people. Anyway, my point is that you have certain herbs, yeah, that can boost your memory. You have certain foods that can make you dumb. I'm not making this up. You have LSD. You have junk food. What they call fast food. No. This is not the truth, because if you read the scriptures, fried chicken is a good thing. He tells you to fry the food with salt, but they're telling you salt is evil for you. No. It's the salt they made in the laboratorium. That's the salt that's evil. And their fried food. Why? Because the oil they put. Let me see. Insects do not eat the rape seed. Here, like soy, their version of soy. You have the original soy plant. They eat it. The Heavenly Father created it. Everything is biodegradable. The rapeseed oil basically is a weed, and they eat it. Okay, insects will not eat it. It is deadly poison. The oil from the rapeseed is 100 times more toxic than soy. They're listen. You have the caucus, right? You should not be taught by them. You should learn from them. The difference between being taught and learning from them is this. Let me see. You're being taught that there are flying reindeers in the North Pole, fat dude on the North Pole, flying with reindeers and stuff like that, coming to bring things through the chimney to your house. But if you learn off of them, and you learn off of history first and foremost, the truth, then you will learn like, hey, wait a minute, you got that from somewhere else. Oh, that goes into devil shit. Oh, the devil shit worship. Nimrod. What? Yeah, that's how you do. You shouldn't be taught by a caucus. You should learn from them. Learn the things that they do. You should learn, like, you should learn off of them. You should learn from them. Don't be taught by them. They're going to teach you things, and you should, they're going to teach you that a man can be a woman. Meanwhile, you should learn from their history that, wait a minute, they used to do this in the Greek times, in the Roman times, in the cave days. They used to do this already. What makes you think you should be taught by them? Because they look prestigious. They look, fancy word, they look like they are supposed to be believed. You know, they have these fancy clothing and all that type of stuff. You know, Versace suits and whatever, man. All these things that they wear. You should watch, you should look this up, and you will find that everywhere you go and buy stuff, rapeseed oil is right there within it. But they changed this word from rapeseed oil. They call it, I think, another canola oil or something. Rapeseed oil, canola oil. You see, that's it. It's oil, known both as rapeseed oil and canola oil. Now, why did they change the name? To confuse you. That's what the caucus does. They confuse you. Mizraim is now Egypt. Now you don't know what it is. You don't know which race it is. Because if I teach you Mizraim, you will know that, oh, that's one of the sons of Ham. So then, therefore, it would be a Hamite. But if I teach you, I'm not talking about me, I'm talking about, you know, in general. If I would teach you Egypt, and then I show you pictures of Arabs and all, and caucus people with pharaoh type clothing on, you might get that in your head. Or if I say pillars, the earth sitteth upon pillars, you would get this in your head. I'm 100% sure you would get this. I'm 100% sure. I don't even have to. You would get this in your head, and then you would think of the Romans and the Greeks. But this is actually made by Hamites. This is made by, look how small these, look how small these people are compared to these things. These were giant Hamites that built these things, and they call it basically the Temple of Jupiter. Now, if you read the book of Matthew, you will see that Jupiter was worshipped by the Ishmaelites. Jupiter was worshipped by the Ishmaelites. They called Barnabas Jupiter, and they called Paul Mercury, which is, Mercury is an idol. Here, Mercury is God, the idol God thing. He was the idol of shopkeeper, merchants, and travelers, and transports of goods and stuff like that, thieves and tricksters. And then Jupiter was then Zeus. Jupiter, right? Jupiter, oh, sorry, that's Dutch. He's the sky of thunder. That's Zeus. That's what they call Zeus. So they called Barnabas Zeus, and they called Paul Mercury, the priest of, basically the priest of Satan. You know, but anyway, sorry. I just went all over the place, but let me just focus on this one again. Sorry about that. But my point is that you have certain foods that can that can play with your mind. That, not play, but it can affect your mind. And you have certain foods that can make you depressed. And you have certain foods that can dumb you down. That can dumb you down. It can be messed up for your waistline, your brain function, processed food, convenience food. Very salty food. Their salt. They call it kitchen salt. Processed proteins. The powders that you buy in order to bulk yourself up, you're gonna get dumbed down. They have these fancy words, man. It's just fucking fats, man. It's not trans fats. It's bullshit, man. They have these. That's why they have 60 or 72 genders or something like that. There's only two, my man. They just make stuff up. This is just talking about fats that they have. Now you have healthy fats, you have their fats. Everything that's natural fats, that's good. Their fats, you gotta watch out for. You have fats in nuts, for example, right? Peanuts and stuff like that. But cashew nuts and stuff like that. But you have, let's say you have cashew nuts on, or salmon. That's healthy fats, right? But if you cook the salmon in their oils, in their canola oil or in their rapeseed oil, you're gonna have a bad time with that one. You're not gonna notice it right away, but keep on using that shit. You're gonna see, and then you're gonna be like, "But I'm eating healthy." Yeah, but you're not cooking healthy because you're using canola oil. Or you're using rapeseed oil, which is the same thing, but they change words because they have a new thing, right? They say that they are not allowed, according to their own fake laws, they are not allowed to not put on the food on the label. To put. Okay, GMOs. Okay. Yeah. So yeah, I already clicked on that, by the way. You can see it's purple. So it says here, GMO is out. Why? Genetically modified organisms is out. But what do they put in then, therefore? Bioengineered meat. So GMO meat. Actually, this one, GMO meat must be labeled here. In what states? I forgot what states. Here, GMO meat has been required in the US for a year. They first and foremost, sorry, first and foremost. First, they was not allowed to actually do that. And here, let me see. I didn't say it good. First, they didn't have to tell you that it was GMO meat. They're asking satanic questions because this should have an answer within itself. No, I do care, and I don't want it to come from America. I don't want it to come from any one of y'all. But that's enough though. We are under the cursor, so yeah, they feed us. That's why the black female don't respect us, because another race feeds us. You ain't even got your own food. Anyway. Here, this is what I actually wanted. Lab-grown meat does have to be labeled, right? So they had a whole issue that back in the days they didn't have to label it. Nowadays they have to label it lab-grown meat. In what states? I forgot what states, man. Sorry about that. Does lab-grown meat have to be labeled on food labels? There's a few states that they have to. Do you believe that? But anyway. Fucking devils. That used to be the fact. This is the truth. They're lying. Yeah, you believe the same race that pushes flying reindeers and bunnies that lay eggs? You still believe them? Come on, man. This is 2024. You should wake up to the snake tongue devil. I have to call them that because they're lying to you. Oh, he's racist. What? What are you talking about, man? I am racist, actually, but this has nothing to do with racism. This has everything to do with what they're doing. I am racist, but not like how you make it come over as, because that is not the truth. What you're saying about me, about you're lying about me, but you gonna pay for that. You gonna pay for that. But anyway, GMO is out, bioengineered is in, as new U.S. food labeling rules take effect. Yeah, because they were ordered to put GMO on the food, but they was like, we're not gonna do that. Fuck it, we're just gonna screw around and just circle like a, you know, have you seen that thing that the men say sorry here and he just straight says sorry, but then the woman say sorry, she's supposed to say sorry here, but then she, no, sorry, here's the woman and here's the sorry, and then she goes, no, it's your fault. that I cheated on you because you wasn't there, you was working all the time, I was trying to take care of you, bitch, and the goddamn kids. You just wasn't there. Trying to blame me? Anyway, that's Esau. He's a strong woman. He's a strong woman. That's the caucus male. He's a very strong, strong, independent woman. But anyway, he just changed his stuff because that's what they do. So this is the reason actually I made the video. I went all up in that olive oil. Sorry about that. Let me just I think it's this one. Yeah, this one. Check this out. Anyway, Kamala Harris. That's the video that I actually wanted to make. The so-called Kamala Harris was actually Kamala Harris, the their baby caucus male seed in an East Indian female. I should have said. Womb is and was a setup. Now this is the series called Limitless, 2015, but the movie is from 2011. Great movie, by the way. I love that movie. I like that movie. I also love the other movie, Lucy. I love a lot of movies actually. Limitless, 2015, and then this is episode 8. Episode 8 of the series. There are 22 episodes, by the way. All right, Nas. Going to Washington, D.C., kicking some ass, taking some names. This is Nas, if I'm correct. Right. Nas
taking some names.
Feel free to picture that however you like.
Okay. Now, this is a female. It looks like it's brown skinned with brown hair, and it shoots some government people being in the government office with the eagle thing here, the flag to flag, with some, you know, files here about, you know, people that they just take files, you know, they got files on people and stuff like that, you know, computer and desk and all that type of stuff here. Garbage things and paper and stuff like that. The White House, 1997, and this is Kamala. Here is the nest and layer one.
Well, it was fun to imagine Nas conquering DC like a.
While it was fun to imagine Nas conquering DC like a boss, let that sink in, right? Conquering DC like a boss. You're not a boss, but you're gonna do it as if you are one, because female is not a boss. But if a male push you there, you can be the boss, right?
boss. At the end of the day.
At the end of the day. Who's that? This is a series of 2015. You see the so-called office, presidential office, the White House. You see a female shooting up a dude with a shirtless sleeve thing here. Not a shirtless sleeve, sorry. A sleeveless suit thing here with arm. This is Donald Trump, bro. I'm telling you.
Yeah. At the end of the day, it's just
a what am I doing? Some
meetings. So it probably looks at the end of
Kamala fighting Donald Trump. 2015. So I go back to over here. Let me see something. The White House. 21-3.
The day. It's just a series of meetings. So it probably looks a lot more like this.
Okay, so I stopped it. And here. This one. And then you type in. This is the movie. You should watch this, by the way. It's dope. The reason I was talking about the Gotu Cola is because Esau has this now. That's why I was a real life limitless pill. I try the real life limitless pill. This is the reason I actually this is the reason I actually went into the Gotu Cola. You have the ginkgo biloba, whatever, man. They got these weird ass names. These are herbs. These are just plants. You could just eat it. And I actually tested this thing. I'm not kidding you. If you have like a memory problem, this thing is, it's real. Yeah, it's real. I'm not. Go test it yourself, man. Like if you have these leaves, like this plant, just test it yourself, man. You're gonna start memorying things. Your memory is gonna be very good. Your eye. So-called depression. So food can actually fix your so-called depression and anxiety. Lower blood pressure, and anxiety has to do with blood pressure. Not all the time, but it's linked to it. Depression also. But then, so you can see that food can have a effect on your mood. It can have an effect on your mind. It can have also an effect on your spirit. Some foods can make you a horny beast. And some foods can make you a man that just desires a woman. You see, there's a difference between a lustful beast and a man that just desires a woman. There's a difference, okay? So these foods can do these things. Drinks can also do it. It's the same thing. You get it in your body, it's the same thing. Food and drinks, the one is liquid, the other one is solid. it can alter your mind. It can alter your physical form, your body, like the Ronnie Coleman thing here. I think it was here. These type of things that he ate or injected it into himself, it changed his body, but it also changed his mind. That's what steroids do. They change your mind and your body, by the way. So don't think this is far-fetched that he actually has these types of pills. But if you watch this movie, you're going to be in fear to take those pills what he has, planted for you, as you should. We know that the Heavenly Father is going to unlock our mind beyond this. So the reason I push this movie to people that just listen to me, or you know, they'll be like, so what type of movies do you suggest or give advice for? Be like, Limitless, go watch that. But you should take away all the nonsense and the drugs and the chemicals that they push, and then you should be like, well, the Heavenly Father is going to give it to us. That's what I want you to get out of that movie. I don't want you to go and take pills like Esau, but I do want you to understand that these things are not far-fetched. They do have this because the Lord created this. The book of Sirach 38 explains this to you. It says it right here. Sirach 38 and 4. It says, the Lord had created medicines out of the earth, and he that is wise will not abhor them. What does abhor mean? It doesn't mean this. Abhor means to ab, means away from, and horror, like horror movie. You're shaking once you see that. That's what horror does to you. Like, should I have... That's what it does to you. Sorry. That's all. Wow. That's horror. No, he didn't really do it good. Think he does it. Yeah, that's what the Lord did to us when he, in the book of Psalms 106, the Lord abhorred us. Anyway, this is not really 100%. This is the 100% what it means, and it doesn't come from the Latin. That's how far they go, because the Latin comes from the Greek, and the Greek comes from the Hebrew. But they will never acknowledge that, because they're the deceiver of the planet. Why would they acknowledge that? The scripture says that it was given unto him to deceive the four corners of the earth. So you would think every word go back to the Latin. But if you check out the Latin, they tell you that the Latin alphabet evolved from the visual similar Etruscan alphabet, which evolved from the Cumean Greek version of the Greek alphabet, which was itself descendant from the Phoenician alphabet, which in turn derived from Egyptian hieroglyphs. This is Mizraim, and this is Canaan. That's what they called them. Mizraim and Canaan. So what is the Phoenician alphabet? That's the Paleo Hebrew. They're lying to you because that is not Phoenician. Why? If you check out the Moabite stone, just check you one word, okay? Check this out. Not one word, I mean a few characters. Here is the F looking thing, and then the Y looking thing, like the Y. Okay, the F and the Y, right? And then you have the thing that look like a Z, but with a stripe in the midst, like this, and then of course like this. Like the Dragon Ball Z logo. Right? Wait. This, like this, right? It looked like a Z, right? Okay. Remember those? Remember the F looking one? and the Y looking one, and then the Z looking one. And then you look at this one here, the Moabite stone, Moabites. Then you look at the F and the Y and the F again, and there you go, there you have the Z looking thing. how can this then therefore be Phoenician? While they show you that the Moabites also had the same language. Come on, man. Their lives are so stupid. It's like it's so stupid. It's like this. Let me see. Ruddy skin complexion. It says here, when your skin becomes red for reasons like exposure to extreme heat and various skin conditions like acne, eczema, and whatever, you know, that's what they call ruddy, right? Ruddy skin complexion. Oh, there you have it. This is ruddy. But anyway, they say that this is ruddy, like the red cheeks here, ruddy complexion, according to them. So this is ruddy complexion. So if you then therefore type ruddy dog, I think they changed that one. They changed that one. Yep, okay, this is ruddy dog. Anyway, you have ruddy cow. Let me get that one. They didn't change this one yet. All of them. You have the dark brown cow. Then you have the brown, bright brown cow. Then you have the brown cow that look orange. You see that it looks orange, but it's brown. But it looks orange. But then you have the light brown. You know, this one doesn't look orange, but this one does. It's all a play on words, man. You know, this one looks like, you know, that thing is brownish. And then it's like a camouflage thing. It's almost like, you know, almost, not almost, but... You know, it's ruddy. This is all ruddy. It's brown and bright brown in the sun. Dark brown if you look at it from another angle. But anyway, they're lying to you. That's the point. And their lies are the reason why I showed you this. Sorry, by the way, is to show you that they cannot cover their lies all over the place 100%. Because or else they would have to adjust this, like the ruddy cow, the ruddy cat. They would have to adjust all this and ruddy paint. They would have to adjust all this. They can't. They can only adjust. They can only adjust this. That's the only thing that they can adjust. How to deal with ruddy skin. But if you take a, like a, how you call these things again? Freckle. If you take one freckle and you splash it on her face, she's a brown skinned woman, female. They're lying to you. But yeah, that's what they do. And you know what's fun? You know what's fun? It's fun that you have to, it's like a game. You know, when the game is too easy, you're going to stop playing the game. And if the game is too hard, you're going to stop playing the game. But if the game is just hard enough to where you still succeed, it's going to be beyond fun, because now you're beating them. And in the, you have to understand, like, the majority of our people, the game is so hard, the game of life is so hard that they just give up. They just... They just give up. They just give up. If you can't beat them, join them. They just give up. They just give up. They be like, fuck it. I want to be like them, because they're the original. They're the most beautiful thing in existence. Without even knowing that, and it's actually the other way around. But anyway, so it's not Phoenician. It's just the paleo hippie. Paleo means ancient. So it's the ancient ways of writing, you could say. The ancient way of writing. That's what we had back in the days. But going back to the Kamala Harrison thing, it is...
Well, it's fun to imagine Naz conquering DC like a boss. At the end of the day,
it's a setup. It has been done since by the way, just because a series is released in 2015, for example, doesn't mean that they made it in 2015. This thing is most likely made in 2014 or 2013. It depends. I would think 2014. Maybe it was the end of 2015, then it could be like, you know, created in January or whatever, and then released in... Oh, September, okay. Maybe it was made in January and then released in September. I don't know. I didn't look it up and... I probably wouldn't even find it. Maybe. I don't know. I didn't look it up. But yeah. So that is how most of the time movies are made. Movies are made a year in advance. Maybe 2 years, 4 years, 5 years in advance. I don't know, man. You know, it depends. It really depends. I have seen movies that was in the making for... For three years, some of them five, some of them 2 years, some of them one. Between 1 year or and 2.5 years or to complete all three productions. For the 5 years, see, it's different, man. 1 year, 2.5, and sometimes 3, 5, you know. It depends on the people, man. If they do it fast, they do it fast. If they do it slow, they do it slow. It just depends on the people. So I can't answer that. I can't 100% answer that, you know. The movie Friday was made very fast. Twenty days. So some movies are made in 20 days, and they're man, they're so dope that I mean, like, it's better than a lot of movies that are made in 4 years. I mean, like, this is real. This is dope. 20 days. It's 20 days, man. Some movies take 20. Months, 20, you know, 20 weeks, 2 years, 5 years, whatever. Okay, so enough of that. So that's the reason why I went into the pill thing. That's the reason why I went into the Got to Cola thing, because you have pills like that. But watch this movie and it will make you understand. Don't take these chemicals that Esau do, man. You know, the limitless pill, like, as how it is presented in the movie, that's fake. Well, I should say, that's exaggerated. But do these things really exist? Yes, it does, because the Heavenly Father created it. The Lord had created medicine out of the earth. He that is wise will not abhor them. So there are things created by the Heavenly Father. If you have the time, just read verse 1 until verse 15. You can also, of course, read the whole chapter. But yeah, 1 and 15, I would suggest for you to read. And They want to normalize this like as it is, like as if it is normal. You should know history, man. You should know history, and then you will find out, like, you will find out why this is so common nowadays. They're showing you this. They're telling you this. They're showing you this. They're showing you this. You should not be taught by the caucus. You should learn from them. Learn how not to be. That's one of the biggest learning curves that you should have. Learn about their history. Learn about what they're actually about. Just learn about them. Just, you know, be taught by a Jacob descendant about them. Don't let them teach you. They're going to teach you that a man can be a woman. You should learn off of them. Then you know, like, oh, this is what you used to do in the Greek days, the Roman days, the cave days. Oh, that's what you was doing. Then you learn. Then you be like, oh, I know what you do. I know what you're doing. Fish high in mercury. Where the fuck the mercury come from? How about that? How about you explain where the mercury comes from? How about that? Why don't you explain that? See? They're going to tell you, like, fish high in mercury. Where does the mercury come from then? Oh, it's just natural all over the place. No. No. That was not around when you people didn't rule the earth. Like how you say that it is around. They're lying to you. This, nobody even knew this word existed, trans fat. What the hell is that? Is that a transgender? That's a skinny person, but then it's fat? It's a skinny fat person. Like, it's skinny, but it identifies as being fat. So then, therefore, it's a skinny fat person. That's, I don't even know what the hell. Turns out, so you just figured it out? Eating all that sugar makes you pretty dumb. So what type of sugar are you talking about? Are you talking about the processed one? Or are you talking about the one that the Heavenly Father created? Which one are you talking about? You see? This is where you get this from. May. It may make you stupid. The may is him. He's the devil. That's his things. And also the other side of the may is, you know, sugar may fuck you up. Yeah, his sugar. Not the sugar of the Heavenly Father. The other may is this one. You may get big like him. And you may not. You know? But I would not advise you to. This is not a steroids taking videos, man. I'm dead set against this bullshit, bro. I'm not with that nonsense. Anyway, 2 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 11. Lest Satan should get an advantage of us, for we are not ignorant of his devices. We are not ignorant of his little tricks. And as you can see here, this is not something that you just make up. In 2015, where was it again? 2015. This is not something that you just make up. In 2015, you have this female going to the White Office. That's the White House office thing. And then, you know, she's fighting the bosses. It's some dude with yellow hair. That's how you call that guy? Donald Trump. This is Kamala Harris, the Edomite terror baby.
It's just a series of...
Those are two Edomites, by the way. The one is funnier than the other. Chomp Chomp is funny. I just look at this guy. This guy is a liar. And I like that about him. He's a liar, and he's a representation of the caucus race. That's why I like him. I like him because he's the definition of a caucus male to me. I really look at him like, well, you're a goddamn liar. But he's funny to me. I like him. Because he's a funny devil. I like devils that make me laugh. I don't like devils that make me angry. Because those are the ones that make, you know, they make me serious. I don't want to be serious all the time. Because serious people are in a danger watch, Dip. He's going to, you know. Because if they see I'm laughing, they'd be like, oh, he's not a threat. He's a happy nigger. I'm a happy nigger, no. You fucking think I'm Pharrell? Pharrell with the I'm happy. I'm not Pharrell, bro. I'm telling you that I'm not Pharrell. I'll tell you that one. But I'm also, but I'm laughing, you know. Till I get that power. And everybody that thinks I'm a clown, you're gonna swallow your own fucking tongue in that day, boy. And I'm not no clown, boy. I don't have red cheeks and pale skin. I'm not no clown, boy. I might laugh like I'm one, but you gonna find out, boy. You're gonna find out. But yeah, so yeah, I just wanted to make that video, and I have talked more than I actually grabbed scriptures, so sorry about that. I didn't even want to make this video that long. Sorry about that again. I shouldn't say that no more, because I can control it anyway, so. Yeah, so. Jupiter was an entity that the Israelites worshipped. Wow. Mercury's also, sorry, let me take this little honey, because it's getting worse right here, actually, sorry. Burn. I can't wait. Heavenly Father willing. So, once that time comes, then they're going to be put where they belong. And they're going to pay for all the wickedness that they have done. Sorry for the chewing. Now, this is the last scripture that I'm going to leave it at that. Psalm 68:23. That thy foot may be dipped in the blood of thine enemies, and the tongue of thy dogs in the same. Our animals are going to feed on y'all. Just like how you. Just like how you did this. On our people. Just like how you did this. They let that dog loose on the jig. They did it on the natives too. the natives had the dogs had native babies. He chopped them in half and fed them to the dogs. Y'all had fun. So the Heavenly Father is going to cause for us to also have fun. We're just waiting. I'm just waiting. House Negro is not waiting, so I shouldn't say we, as in the whole nation. House Negro is not waiting. They're waiting to get that, you know, to get that caucus pee-pee in their mouth, you know, so. They just waiting for that, but the field ones, you know, the field natives, the field and the Latinos, they're waiting to get that revenge. Oh shit, look at this one over here. That's the face. This one is the arm. This one is the head. The elbow. There's a severed head right there. Oh shit, this one is in the neck or something like that. Damn. That's how wolves kill you. These are the type of dogs that they used to let loose on them jakes. These jakes, the natives. And then they was just chilling, you know, having a ball. You know, having fun, you know, chilling, whatever they're doing. It's all good, though. You know, be angry and sin not. Okay. Ephesians 6:11. Put on the whole armor of the Heavenly Father. Why? That ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. Against his little tricks, his lies, devious and cunning stratagems employed to manipulate or persuade someone to do what one wants. Stratagem. A plan or scheme, especially one used to outwit an opponent or achieve an end. That's what they have been doing for centuries right about now. And they have been successful in it because the Lord allowed them to. The chariot that cover it, and I made thee so. That's what the Lord said in Ezekiel 28. The Lord created you for to cover. That's why you cover. Right? Anyway, let me leave it at that. So, yeah, there you have it. So with that, I'm going to say, sorry, let me see something. So with that, I'm going to say, Shalom.